Sri Gurubhyo Namaha children, we welcome you to our online learning initiative Ekalaiva. Yesterday we discussed about secularism. We discussed about the meaning of secularism, objectives of secularism. Today we are going to discuss about features of a secular state. First one, principle of liberty. Second one, principle of equality. And third one, principle of neutrality. So these are all the three features of a secular state. So first one, principle of liberty. The state permits the practice of any religion. The state can't compel the citizens to follow a particular religion. So liberty means we are free to follow whatever we desire, we wish. So the state permits the practice of any religion. So we have many religions, many people follow different religions in our country, isn't it? So nobody can compel us to follow this, follow that. So the state permits the practice of any religion to the citizens of the state. Next one, principle of equality. The state does not give preference to any religion over another. So the state does not have any power to support particular religion or to work in favor of certain religion. So state it can't give preference to any particular religion or to compel the people of the state to follow that particular religion. So all the religion will be treated equally. Next one, principle of neutrality. The state remains neutral in religious matters. The state cannot show partiality over certain religion. So its state should remain neutral. Whether this particular religion has done a mistake or that particular religion has done some illegal issues, means both the things should be equally treated. State should not be in favor of a group which belongs to that particular religion. So state should stay neutral in religious matters. So in our previous paragraph, we discussed about secular state, isn't it? So a secular state is the one in which the state officially, it will not promote any one religion as a country's or state's official religion. So all the religions are treated equally. So it gives to every citizen not only the equal right to freedom of speech, freedom to express, or freedom to right to profess, practice and propagate any faith of their own choice. It gives freedom to all the citizens. So the state observes an attitude of neutrality and impartiality towards all the religion. So in a secular state, no one is given preferential treatment, and the state does not discriminate any person on the basis of their religion or religious practices and beliefs. So all citizens are eligible to enter government service irrespective of their faith. And there should be absolutely no religious instructions in educational institutions and no taxes to support any particular religion. So these are all the common features followed by the secular state. Now, importance of secularism. So the concept of secularism evolved in India as equal treatment of all religions. We need secular state to maintain peace and harmony between people of various religious ideologies. So we need a secular state. It should give equal importance to all the religions, and also it should respect and honor the people, those who are following any religion. It is a part of democracy which grants equal rights. Now, constitution and secularism. Secularism, it is the part of our Indian constitution, and the makers of the Indian constitution aware that a strong and united nation could be built only when all section of people had the freedom to practice their religion. So while making the constitution itself, the members, those who involved in the process of making our constitution, the great persons, they would have got an idea that when all the sections of people are treated equally only, our country can follow the democratic policies which we are following, isn't it? So according to that, we should not be partial towards any particular religion. So the basic aim of our constitution is to promote unity and integrity of the nation, and at the same time, individual faith and belief should not be exploited by others. So in our constitution, secularism is given more importance, and they had lot of things in their mind before framing the laws also. And the word secularism, it was not mentioned in our constitution when it was adopted in 1950, and later the word secular incorporated in the preamble through the 42nd amendment of the Indian constitution. So you know, our country is a socialist, secular, a democratic country. So the basic aim of our constitution is to promote unity and integrity of the nation, so along with the individual dignity. There is no state religion followed in our country. So the freedom of religion guaranteed under the constitution is not confined to a citizen alone, but extends to persons, those who belong to other states and other countries also. So in this picture you can see an Indian Hindu temple. Actually this was constructed in 19th century Hindu temple in a place called Khajuraho. And in this you can see a Jain cupola, a Buddhist stupa, and Muslim style doom. In place of usual shikara, you can, in this architecture, they have united all the religions. They have given importance to all the religious architecture style. So this is one example which shows that even though we belong to different religions, we are united as Indians. Now, secular education. So, children should be aware of this secularism. So, secular education is very essential to our children. Secular education is needed for various reasons. Secular education develops moral and humanistic outlook among the students, and it removes narrow-mindedness, and children will have dynamic views and they will be enlightened view. They will not show any partiality towards the students, those who belong to other religions. And it is needed to train the youth to be a good citizen. So they should not be partial towards the colleagues or towards other citizens, those who belong to other religions. And it is very essential to strengthen our democratic values and to give wider vision towards life and to develop the attitude of the citizens. So they should not exploit or they should not dominate others, those who belong to other religions. So secular education is needed for various purposes. Okay, children, in this lesson we discussed about secularism. So we discussed various things about secularism. So our country is a multi-religious country. So we have to tolerate other religions also. So we should not exploit or we should not make difference on the basis of the religion. And secularism, it is very essential for smooth functioning of the democratic country. And meaning of the secular state. A state which does not promote any one religion or state religion is called a secular state. And our Indian constitution, it gave privileges to all the citizens to follow their own religious beliefs and practices. So our Indian state works in various ways to prevent religious domination. Okay, children, we gained knowledge about the secularism and also about our country's participation, how our country acts as a secular state. Thank you, children.